Ingham, a small village just to the north of RAF Scampton and south of RAF Hemswell, had been considered for use as an airfield during 1936, but had been deemed too small a usable area for an airfield. With the onset of war, however, and the desperate need for more airfields, Ingham was re-evaluated and chosen for the site of a satellite airfield for Hemswell. Work commenced during 1941 on an airfield with a grass flying field, which allowed for three strips, north-south and southwest-northeast at 1600 yards each, and east-west at 1200 yards. The field was surrounded by a concrete peritrack, off which lay 34 pan-type dispersals. Three hangars were provided, one B1 to the southwestern side of the airfield, and two T2s, one to the north and the other to the east side of the airfield. It was provided with a watch office with operations room for bomber satellite stations type 734541, with the addition of type B operation room to plan 1307941 and control room to plan TD346. Two bomb stores were constructed, the first on a minor road to the south of the airfield, with the second to the north of the airfield. A house located on the flying field between the landing strips was left standing and used as the officers' mess. The living and communal sites were mainly spread west of the village of Ingham, with a few to the north of the airfield. The population was given as 107 officers and 1,295 other ranks, with, in addition, 12 WAF officers and 122 WAFs. RAF Ingham opened in early May 1942 as the satellite for Hemswell in No. 1 Group Bomber Command. On the 18th, No. 300 Polish Squadron arrived from Hemswell with their Vickers Wellington 4s. During its time at Ingham, No. 300 exchanged their Wellington 4s for Wellington 3s. On May the 30th, the squadron took part in the RAF's 1,000 bomber raid on Cologne, and again on June the 26th in the 1,000 bomber raid on Bremen. June saw No. 300 carrying out 94 sorties laying mines off the Frisian Islands. July and August were busy months for the Polish bombers and crews, and aircraft were being worn down by attrition. By early September, the squadron had 20 full crews, but only 9 serviceable Wellingtons. The war went on, crews and aircraft were lost in operations and accidents. During the Bremen raid on the night of the 4th of September, one Wellington, which had lost 3/4 of the fuselage cover, made it back to Ingham. The press covered the feat, stating that it belonged to No. 300 Polish Squadron, while, for obvious reasons, not mentioning any of the unit's details or operational base. On the Dusseldorf raid of September the 10th, another crew was lost. October the 12th, an aircraft was written off with no casualties. October the 15th, the Cologne raid, with another crew lost. November the 3rd, another crew lost while laying mines of the coastal water off Brest. November the 8th, two crews lost while laying mines off the Danish coast. December the 6th, and another crew was lost on the Mannheim raid. Crews and aircraft joined the squadrons from the training schools and factories, and the war went on. 1943 arrived, and on the 31st of January, No. 300 Squadron returned to Hemswell. No. 199 Squadron arrived from Blighton on the 3rd of February with their Wellington 3s and immediately began to convert to Wellington 10s. No. 199 was to be a brief resident, and on the 20th of June, having flown 50 operational missions, which were mainly mine laying, they departed south for Lakenheath in Suffolk to make way for Numbers 300 and 305 squadrons, so that runway construction and general upgrading could commence at Hemswell. The move was not a popular one among the crews because of Ingham's bumpy landing surface and widely dispersed poorer quality accommodation. The Polish squadrons took part in the 700 bomber raid over Hamburg on July the 24th, when Window, the aluminium strips to confuse German radar, was used for the first time. All the Ingham aircraft returned, although one of the 305 squadrons crash-landed at Trusthorpe, 2 miles south-southeast of Mablethorpe, due to running out of fuel. But all the crew were safe. The war ground on. On the Essen raid of July the 25th, No. 300 Squadron lost an aircraft and crew, followed on the 2nd of August by the loss of an aircraft and crew on the Hamburg raid. 3rd of August, a 305 Squadron Wellington with all the crew was lost to night fighters after bombing Hamburg. And while laying mines off the Frisian Islands, 15th of August, another 300 Squadron Wellington was lost, having been shot down. Two of the crew were rescued from the sea. No. 305 Squadron stay at Ingham was to be a brief one, and on the 5th of September they departed with their Wellingtons for RAF Swanton Morley in Norfolk. Meanwhile, No. 300 slogged on alone. On the night of the 24th, 25th of October, a number of crews gave an accurate report in the debriefing of German ships in the Channel. Quickly passed to the command at the Nore, the Royal Navy was able to intercept an attack by a force of 25 E-boats on an East Coast convoy, sinking 4, damaging 7, and taking 19 prisoners. On November the 30th, No. 300 Squadron's RAF Robert dropped the squadron's 2,000th mine. The crew were rewarded an extra 48 hours pass and a bottle of liquor by the CO, and congratulated by Air Marshal Harris, who wrote, "Heartiest congratulations to the whole personnel of Squadron 300 on the operation of laying last night, in good and painstaking fashion, their 2,000th mine. It is a most valuable contribution towards winning the war with Germany, and affords further proof of the splendid spirit of cooperation animating both our air forces. I am proud to be in command of you." It was signed simply, Harris. Ingham's flying field began to be used by No. 16 Polish Service Flying Training School from the 11th of December, due to the very poor condition of its base at RAF Newton, but no personnel from the school were ever to be stationed at Ingham on a permanent basis. The same month saw a reduction of No. 300 to just 8 aircraft and 12 crews, as the squadron was to convert to the Avro Lancasters, and crews were detailed to No. 1662 Heavy Conversion Unit to familiarise themselves with the new aircraft. Had 1943 had seen 300 Squadron make 942 operational sorties, for a total of 62 airmen killed in action, and 10 taken as prisoners of war. 1944 began with damp and dreary weather setting in. When the weather allowed, A Flight continued to fly operationally on Wellingtons, while 17 crews trained on Lancasters. Ingham was not suited to the four-engined heavy and suffered from a severe lack of trained ground personnel, not enough aircraft, no hard runways, and only a short takeoff. The course was transferred to Hemswell. The first crews to graduate never returned to 300 Squadron, but were sent to 138 Special Duties Squadron. On the 2nd of February, No. 16 SFTS returned to RAF Newton. No. 1687 Bomber Defence Training Flight formed at the station on the 15th of February, with 6 Spitfire Mark IIs. Later in the month, on the 21st, Wellington JA117, BHF, became the last of the RAF Wellingtons to be lost from frontline duties when the crew failed to return from mine laying near Brest. On the 1st of March, No. 300 Squadron and their Wellingtons moved to Faldingworth to re-equip with Lancasters. Their departure saw the end of operational units based at the airfield. On the 7th, No. 1481 Bomber Gunnery Flight arrived from Binbrook with their Miles Martinets in a target towing role, and they were joined on the 10th by the Night Bomber Tactical Training School, which arrived from High Wycombe. The school didn't stay long, and the following month was moved to Hemswell. With an RAF Ingham in Suffolk, it was not unheard of that both personnel and aircraft turned up at the wrong station. Therefore, on the 24th of November, Ingham in Lincolnshire was renamed RAF Cameringham. With the change of name also came a change of control, and on the 1st of December, RAF Cameringham became a substation under the control of No. 15 base, with the parent airfield at Scampton. But Ingham's time as an operational airfield was running out. On the 4th of December, No. 1687 and No. 1481 flights departed for Scampton, and on the 1st of January 1945, RAF Cameringham was considered surplus to requirements and closed. All flying ceased, and it was placed on a care and maintenance order. it would see out the rest of the war being used either to store equipment or to house personnel working at other nearby stations. From April to June 1945, Cameringham was used by No. 2799 Squadron, RAF Regiment. On the 9th of July, No. 16 Polish School of Technical Training arrived from Locking, and on the 1st of November, No. 1 Polish Resettlement Unit was occupying some of Ingham's accommodation sites. They were joined on the 14th by No. 4 Polish Aircrew Holding Unit, a holding unit for demobbed Polish aircrew awaiting repatriation or settlement. No. 16 School and No. 4 Aircrew Holding Unit were disbanded on the 7th of December 1946, while No. 1 Polish Resettlement Unit stayed at Ingham until February 1948. The airfield was then abandoned and sold off, and the land was returned to agriculture. A local group was set up in 2010 to convert the former Sergeant's Mess into a museum celebrating the history of RAF Ingham, and this growing museum is open to visitors.